Hello, welcome to Pasty Goggles. I look a bit pasty, don't I? Look. I don't look well. I've got a bit of flu and I'm like blots, white, red. It's not good, look. If I go, I'll suddenly go red. It's not good. It's not good. Plus, I'm not shaved and I'm all white bits and everything. Excuse me. You know, if I shaved the lot off, I look 50 years younger. But I look like Mr. Potato Head. Because I've got like a round-shaped head. If I go like that, you see what I mean, look. It's horrible, isn't it, look? It's round. It's terrible. That kind of goes, okay, it's a person. It's not a potato. Anyway, I do digress. We've got another one of the GBBH. Another one of the Maxims. They've got two, I believe, in it. Seems a bit unfair that they've got two in it, but each their own. I think they have to pay. From what I've seen of other breweries and everything else, talking to other breweries, I think they have to pay quite a bit in order to actually go into the GBBH competition. And only then, if you win it or do well in it, you kind of start getting money back in it, you know. As far as I know, I could be wrong. But I think Sainsbury's get a fair bit of that out of them. But look, it can make a brewery. It can make a brewery and make them big time, like winning the lottery. So, if they win it, they win the lottery. You've got 20 beers now. It's down to 20 beers. You know. If they're in it still, then it's worth their money, isn't it? You know. Even for the publicity alone. Every time your beer's seen on a shelf, every time it's bought for £1.50, you know, it might not be massive money in your pocket, but it will suddenly, people will go, "Ooh, I really like this." You know, if you've got your best beers out there, and something that you can slap people in the face with and they'll go, "Oh, that's really lovely." Then you're gonna win so much custom. And once they buy one thing from you, you've got your hook in them. Then you must have, every brewer must have a mixed case. You've got to have a mixed case. You must have a mixed case. If you're a brewer and you ain't got a mixed case, you're an idiot, you know. I ain't pointing this at anyone if you haven't got a mixed case, but if you're a brewer and you've got enough beers to have a mixed case, which is three is enough beers for a mixed case, two even, but three is enough beers, you can have four. Pardon me. But certainly if you've got a big range of beers and you ain't got a mixed case, then that's ridiculous. And, you know, you that's your best advert. Is, you know, people are phoning you up and they've already been... You've already got a bit of York in them. It's like getting York into a fish and not striking. You know, when you get York in a fish, the float goes down and you go, "Oh, I'll just leave it." Hopefully the fish will run in that direction and get it caught in his lip. And the fish is going, "Oh," like that. Shaking its head, and boom, out comes the hook, you know. But that's got it, you know. And it's like doing that, you know. You sell on you if someone's phoned your. But I'm sorry, I'm taking minutes again. People just look at the video and go, "Oh, so many minutes long. I won't bother." They're actually starting to get used to it now, and I've noticed. I put a video up now, and the old views are going, you know, quite quickly as well, which is lovely. Yeah, it's lovely, you know, because there are people out there that are reviewing, yeah, it's lovely to kind of do an honest review, and the views are going, you know, that sort of thing, and it's because you're thinking, that's all the more power to the good beers against the bad beers. And the bad beers are getting quite enough publicity and quite enough kind of a BS, let's say, without us heading to it, you know. So, you know, I think you've got to be as honest, very honest as you can. And that means be really honest, even sometimes if you're going to hurt people. And I hate hurting brewers, especially when they've really put their heart and soul into something. And then you go, no, not that. It's very much my opinion, you know. And I always say, that's why I say try it, buy it and like it. Try it, buy it and let me know, you know. Try it, buy it and love it, you know. Because most of the time, if I say try it, buy it and love it, you'll try it, buy it and love it, you know. Sometimes, obviously, it's like a Marmite moment. I might love it. And you might go, tell, have you gone crazy? And it does happen, you know, it does happen. It happens quite a lot, but you make your own minds up, you know. You know what I mean? Anyway, how long am I in? Someone give me a shout when I ramble. Just say, tell! So, you're rambling. This is Maxims, or Mixems, if you'd put it back the front in the mirror. Mixems, American Pride. Not sure, again, where we get American Pride. It's an India parallel. It's not an American IPA, I don't think. It's 5.2. We're talking, the first thing they're on about is the 100 years, blah, blah, blah. Of history. Excuse me. Has been specifically selected as one of the new craft beers that blah 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 blah. Sorry, new craft. I've gone over because I had one of these a little while ago. New craft beers that Maxim Brewery produces that can now be enjoyed from the bottle. American Pride is a strong IPA brewed using a combination of special American hops to make... Why don't they list them? To make a perfectly modern drinkable ale, but one that gives a bitter nose and a dry mouthfeel on the palate. Well, that sounds nice. That sounds like they're probably using a Citra Amarillo. Citra and Fuggles Goldings or something. Probably Goldings. Right, let's give it a go. Quite fizzy. Smells quite nice. Black, plain, creme. Let's put in the umpty dumpty umpty dumpty umpty dumpty do. The old umpty dumpty glass. He's helping himself to a head. I'm holding him back. Right, just let him go on the last bit. There we go. Fluffy lily white head. That sort of colour of thingy. Call it what you like, call it light mahogany, call it copper. Getting peppery notes. Getting little plummy sort of, weird little, for something that's this light, you're getting little plummy pruny edges on it. Little dried strawberry notes, little kind of dried strawberry and then Weetabix-y things, that sort of thing. Really quite pleasant. Almost a slightly sherbet-y edge. Nice little toffee notes underneath. Quite a lot of complex and different flavours going on. Aromas. Let's hope they're in the flavours as well. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. Oh, it's nice. Yeah, that's nice. I'm not getting American hops in massive amounts, which is kind of good in an IPA. It's an American Pride IPA. If it's an American IPA, I kind of think it's falling short of the remit of an American IPA. But if it's an IPA, it's nice that it's becoming a nice, balanced, proper dish, you know. Pardon me. Got a burps. Good Lord. Yeah, it's a nice balanced dish. You know, it's not ordering the pizza and finding that you've got a whole pineapple sitting on top of your pizza and it, you know. Or 5 punnets of tomatoes on top of the pizza or whatever, you know, that sort of thing. That's kind of a nice, well balanced sort of dish. That's nice. I like that. Let's have another go. Weird little things. When you've got it in your mouth and you're tipping, you're getting lemon and grapefruit. When you drop it down, you're suddenly getting darker fruits like plums and mainly plums. You're getting sort of plum sort of notes. Little tiny hints of the ones I lose words in my mind. The ones with the little seeds in. Pomegranates. Little hints of pomegranates as you're tipping it down. And then suddenly afterwards, you're getting little sharp fruits coming again. And you're getting little kind of yellow grapefruit sort of smells, tastes and things like that. And a little sharp little lemony edges. But also still getting the malts coming in there as well. But light malts, kind of, you know, it looks slightly darker than it's telling you. See, what it's telling you is a little bit more caramelly. Let's have a look. Yeah. It tastes yellow rather than orange, if you get what I'm saying. It's kind of silly working on my silly brain. But that is lovely. I like that. It really is lovely. I can imagine having that after a big workout, really getting a thirst on. And that just crisping down a treat. No kind of bottle conditioning to talk of there. So that is the Maxim American Pride. Really lovely. Really, really nice. Now, I did have the Maxim, and I ain't got none left of it. Have I? Little bit of difference. Not a lot, though. But it's quite similar in ways to the Swedish Blonde as well. But a whole ABV difference. Listen, give them a go. Certainly give that a go. Bum, 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 bum. Try it by like it. That's what I think. Let me know. Cheers. And it's how you can play.